The problem of evil has perplexed us as theologians through the centuries, and anyone that's got an easy answer to that question has not understood the question. Theologians generally have responded in one of three ways. The one set of responses will question what is evil really, and is it the case that what we think of as evil will turn out to be somehow part of a greater good? Or there are various ways of rethinking whether there is genuine evil in the world. Other theologians will even challenge the goodness of God. The protest theologians have a kind of a raging against God, requiring the "how long, O Lord" kind of response that you see in Psalms of lamentation, that struggle with whether and in what sense God is good. Another line of approach that theologians will take is to try to understand better the nature of the working of God's power in the world. You know, what kind of power is that? My own approach has been the third of these. I am a process theologian, and we raise questions about what is perfect power? And our traditional notions of that have sometimes led to an idea of power in the mode of domination and control. And if God exercises that kind of power in the world, then indeed whatever happens in world process is God's doing. And you've got a serious theodicy issue there. If, however, we thought about God's power in a different kind of way, a life-giving, world-generating, empowering power, which I think is the power we find in the scriptural witness, then maybe perfect power does not control what happens in world process. And you have a kind of, I think, workable theodicy. Others could speak to the other two frameworks, but that gives you a hint of what the third option offers.